actually remembered something between recordings which might be helpful. Provided I remember right. Namely...
Come out, wherever you are.
Okay, there's
What's
one.
What's that? Please, don't hurt me.
Well, now that I'm caught anyway, I... Yeah, two torches. Well, on the plus side, I do not have to cross her line of sight for the first door. So, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Okay, so the bowman. The bowman cometh. And hell goeth. And then those guys going through the kitchen come. And I drop a quick save. And ready my lockpick. Almost said toothpick. No? Okay, I think that's enough. Yeah. That was a good spot, I'd say. And the circly guys are coming back this way. Yes. He goes there. Yeah. Ooh. At least now I should get a bit more lockpicking in once the bowman goes back. Actually, I suppose I could have distracted Mr. Bowman, and that would have helped. Well, hindsight. Okay. Now, it looks like there's nothing here, but there is something on the... up there, on the... well, I don't know what to call them, rafters, ceiling. Just trying to okay, let's try this shoot at least, since when you are targeting something you can use or pick up outside of in the surrounding world, you see the inventory icon, it goes smaller and stops spinning, so... Ooh, water arrow. Just what I needed. Another water arrow. Oh, yes. I think there should also be... some... piece of valuable to pick up. No, I don't see any. Well, do this. I think the door just opened and whoa, what is going on with my frame rate? Hello? Right. We are back. But everybody seems to keep going away right now, so okay. Now that we got all set up for going to the next room. I am again breaking my own rules about not dousing torches. But as I said, that lady is going to be very alarmed if she sees Garrett running across the doorway, and well, I find dousing a few torches to be the lesser of two evils. And we can just sit here in the shadow and open this lock. Okay, you are coming and so are you. I think I'll just sit here until you are gone. He already caught a glimpse. Now, over here. Oh, hello. I see you there, gemstone. And that looks like a fire arrow. And that it is. Let's make sure it doesn't look like there's anything else. Yeah, and I think 1541 is the maximum loot to get at this point. Clearing out from the sewers and all from this house. So we are good to go. Those two guys. They are in the kitchen now. And I'll grab that one water arrow from here. Thank you very much. Now in front of an oven doesn't seem like the natural place for water. But I don't know, maybe it's condensation from all the steam from cooking or something. And well, let's be a tidy thief and okay, there is the. I can't close that for some reason. Oh, great. We have this to deal with again. Those two guys in the basement who are far too jittery. Hooray! Let's see how this goes. Now, of course, one thing I could try is to open the cage of the giant spider so that it might kill the servants, but which I have tried that sometimes, but it does not seem to work all that well, mainly since those servants are non-combatants, so great. So when they do see it, the spider on the loose, they just run away, and the spider is not that fast. It doesn't keep up with them. I mean, if they stayed and fought with the spider, that would be another matter. Yeah. Setting the spider loose, not helpful. And by the way, you can hit the buttons with the arrow and have them activate like that. Because that button is, well, quite small, so it's not easy to hit, but it is possible to hit it from here. Oh, great. This might take some time. And I think I've mentioned this before, but I might as well say it again. One quirk of the engine appears to be that in doorways there is often this small sliver of complete shadow. I think it might be on the exact spot where the door lies when it's closed. Okay, I am now going to wait until you come through that archway. Okay? Good. Now you turn around, I'll drop a quick save and the spider appears to be glitching through the bars. Okay, where is the other guy? Oh, no, crap. No. Okay, what if I try following right?
There's a guy over here.
And now the other guy comes. So, presuming the other guy comes right through here this time also. Of course, now he doesn't, or he just... Oh! Hallelujah, brother! Okay. Oh, yeah! And now to get back through here again. Lovely. Okay, where is... Okay, there's the guy with the sword coming. So let's wait for him to go by before we run through. And I just now noticed... Looks like the bowman has a bunch of arrows on his back. At least I think that's what that texture is supposed to represent. In the sequel, they actually have quivers on their back, and there's a nice little addition. I think pretty much...
What's happening?
Pretty much... Always in the sequel.
Quiet now.
When there is a bowman, you can pickpocket arrows from his quiver. Pick quiver? Of course. But however, As hilarious as that would be, unfortunately, you can never grab all the arrows away from the bowman. And I'm going to wait here for you to pass. Okay, you come over here. And then you go up the slope. Thank you. And now we are back in the sewers. Oh, joyous day. Right. Where's the... Oh, there's a ladder there. Hi, I didn't notice you before. Yeah. This open area with pillars here. Yeah, on the other side is the room of that guy with the key to the mansion's, or the door to the mansion's basement. Let's see, what's this way? Oh, right, now I remember. Let's be a tidy thief in the sewers and close the doors behind. And this is the storage room. Okay, I don't hear footsteps. Now I hear footsteps. Oh! Bright light, bright light. And poke in here to get. Oh! Oh yeah! And now we are... Oh. That area. I think I'll explore one area we passed by. The way here. And...
You're gonna learn what pain is all about.
Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Yeah, well, okay, that sword man, as I recall, he turns around. Well, this should be dark enough corner to... does he turn around? Okay, he turns that way. Oh! Okay, here. Caught a glimpse, but didn't go into full alert mode. Whoops. Yeah. Anyway, the place I want to explore is where that swordman just went. So let's wait for him to come back. The bowman is going to go all the way back to the point where he first noticed something, and that should give a bit of time. And the swordman is taking longer than I expected. Okay, now he's coming back. was also close. Okay, first here. Push down all these switches. Which opens doors over there. And also this door. Here, oh, there he is.
Look at that.
It's quiet now.
Okay, I'm going to hide in the darkness here and wait for him to pass by. Oh yeah, all there is to get here is some water arrows and... nothing else really. And this is actually the entrance to the mansion of the other guy, Donald's house. My green's quarters in the southeast arches. Now, McGrin was the guy over here, roughly. Guy with the fancy bookshelves and fireplace and such, which we also robbed. Now, that note by the door suggests he would have the key to it. Oh, yeah, I didn't really show it off, but the door is locked and it can't be picked. Now, it suggests that the Mugrin guy would have the key to it, but he doesn't. So we have to find an alternate way in. It sounds like Mr. Swordsman is coming this way, maybe. Is he? Oh yeah, he just got up from that middle section, I think. Yeah, there he comes. So, now we just... go here and... in there, but he is going to come back out. And then... actually, this is actually a good rhythm for these guys to have in regard to each other. Okay, he's gone. And I'm going to... well... this is a good spot as any to stop for now. So next time we will be going to that guy Donald and maybe find... well, we probably won't be finishing this in the next video, but hey! Now we have the key and we are on the way to the grand prize.